with some orange muscat.
Yeah.
Can I try the artist series?
The artist series Fumé Blanc. So it's a oaked Sauvignon Blanc.
Yeah.
Still fruity, definitely an oaky finish. Uh-huh. Almost smoky, like hickory.
Uh-huh.
Can I grab any wine, or are you just?
Yeah, I'm gonna get the art. Yep, and the Super Ego, please.
That was good, wasn't it?
Yes, it was. I like unoaked.
And our reds are big and bold. And it was such a nice compliment this morning. We had one gentleman who came specifically because he read about, he's French, he read about our rosé and said, it's exactly what he wanted.
Oh, that's nice.
So what kind of wines do you like?
I think whites more than reds, but I'm trying to get more into reds. I like definitely fruit forwards. I like low tannin, low acidity. I'm not a dry person.
Where are you from?
I'm from Prince George.
How long have you been in the valley for?
Well, we've been traveling for since last Friday.
Okay.
Cool. And we're heading up to Kelowna tomorrow.
Yeah. And then returning back to Prince George. Yes, please.
I am. We are just following the green dots today.
Following the green dots,
okay. We are. So this is Pinot Gris. You as well.
Thank
you. I'm sure today.
Hello.
Hello.
How are you?
Good.
Good. I'd love so. I don't know much about you guys.
You have been waiting for them. So, pear wine, it's our lightest and dry silver wine, and it's Bartlett pear. So, really nice nose of that Bartlett pear, but nice and light on the palate. And good on a hot day, I think. Goes down really nicely. And fairly low acidity naturally, but it has enough to give that nice little crispness.
Yeah. Wow. Oh, yeah, I thought there would be a bigger sign. Gauging interest, we'll snag one of your cards.
Yeah.
It's, I know you guys have an Okanagan Wine Festival at the beginning of October. Ours is at the end of October.
Okay, so that would work well for most wineries because then they're already done all their events.
Yeah, exactly. Bench 1775. Oh, that's nice.
So pretty good. And then we've got some long finish chocolate because they have
sure.
The way of the bistro, and that's the way. Hillside. Yeah, perfect spot.
Welcome to Red Blue Street.
Yeah, first time here for us.
So you want to try three sips every time you try any wines. You always want to do three sips, sip number one through five from your palate. Neutralize your palate, sip number three from your palate.
No one has ever mentioned that before.
So there you go, give it to me.
All right.
So this is our 2014 reserve.
Because after you have that sweeter truffle, it kind of tones the sweetness down in that ice wine, so you get more of those fruity flavors out of it. Enjoy.
It's 1977.
Yeah?
I still remember what my lawyer told me to this day.
What did he say?
You're going to plant what?
You're going to plant what? Grapes?
Grapes. So they pull them out. Why are you planting? They're pulling them out. That's because they got the wrong ones planted.
Yeah?
He knew nothing about
what to plant. And, oh, that's got a great aroma.
That's right? Viognier. The industry was based originally on Lambrusco varieties that switched to hybrids, which is a cross between vinifera and Lambrusco, and then eventually turned to vinifera, which are the European noble grapes.
Wow, that doesn't smell or taste like any Viognier I've actually had so far on this trip.
Different winemaker, different vineyard, different soil type.
Yeah.
Different technique, different wine.
Yeah, that's very nice.
Pinot Noir. This Pinot is the featured wine at all four restaurants at the Fairmont in Lake Louise.
Oh, really?
The sommelier selected it as the best Pinot Noir on their menu bench. He made several trips to the area and he selected ours.
Oh, I love that smell.
And we are 100% estate. I've never bought grapes for my winery in 30 years.
Wow.
I grow my wine. I grow all my grapes. Everything's on site. It's raining again.
Yeah.
Want to taste
it? No, thank you.
I don't believe it. It's been raining for 8 weeks.
Well, actually, we've been really, really good. This is the first time we've got anything that even closely resembles rain since our beginning of our journey in Osoyoos a few days ago. So we've done quite well. Our hometown is raining, though.
Where's your hometown?
Prince George.
Prince George, Northern BC. And it is raining there.
Oh, what's this one? Oh, Tempranillo.
Tempranillo is a Spanish varietal.
Yeah.
It's the only Tempranillo on Aramata Bench. We call it Michela. Michela means blended Italian. I blended Merlot and kept from.
Yeah, because we had... Ooh. That's not bad. We were sampling Tempranillo at Jackson Triggs, way down south.
They had a Tempranillo?
Yeah.
So that means there's four of us then, because Stag's Hollow has one and Mooncrisser has one.
But you would still be the only one in Aramata.
Yeah, I'm the only one on the bench.
Yep.
Neil, okay, next wine is Merlot.
Is Merlot growing in popularity?
Merlot is the most widely planted grape, red grape in BC.
Oh, really? Oh, yeah.
Always has been.
I always see it everywhere.
Yeah, it always has been.
Yeah.
Now, my Tempranillo is Tempranillo, Merlot, and Cab Franc.
Oh, okay.
I put it on the back label. Mm-hmm. My Setagopa has Cab Franc.
A little bit of everything, yeah, yeah.
So whatever's left over is a Merlot Cabernet.
Right.
In 2012, there was not enough Cab Franc to go around, so Merlot got stiffed. So it was the first 100% varietal of Merlot in 10 years.
Okay.
Setagopa, that's the name of our Meritage Bordeaux blend.
Yeah, look at that. I can get out there.
We call it Setagopa, which is a family nickname from Abruzzo, Italy, where I was born.
Yeah, Setagopa?
Setagopa.
I was in Italy last year, actually.
Oh. So that's our Setagopa. And our cellar release program, the next one, is where I bring out a wine from a cellar that's anywhere from 9 to 10 years old.
Oh, really?
I started with the 05 vintage last year.
Mm-hmm.
Sold out quickly. We had 500 bottles. The 06 sold out last week.
Oh, really?
2016, and my line was 10-year-old line, 10-year-old
line.
But the phone kept ringing, and people kept asking, because word gets out, and all these bus drivers.
Yeah, 10-year-old lines
tell each other. So yesterday, we took out 2007 Merlot Cab Franc.
Yeah, that's close enough. I can sit on a cellar for another year.
Time. Time in a bottle. I'm also holding back a little bit more of every one of those that are sold out.
Mm.
Be opened in the next 10 years when they're 20 years old.
Wow.
If I don't make it that far, my daughter will.
Exactly.
Or my grandson will.
Generational.
Yeah. It'll be nice.
Exactly.
And this is our dessert wine. You know how ports are made?
Yep. Well, I'm Portuguese.
Ah. And then you know that parts of fortified wines are brandy.
Yeah.
Halfway through the fermentation cycle in order to stop the ferment.
Yeah.
So first I need brandy.
Yeah.
So I take wine up to Maple Leaf Spirits. He distills my wine for me. He gives me back the brandy for my own wine.
Really?
At 89% alcohol.
Nice.
I set that aside because I want to be 100% estate.
Right.
Then I pick Tempranillo, which is a grape that's used for port.
Right.
And I get it fermenting. When it's about 7% alcohol, I put enough of the 89% to bring it to 18. That kills the yeast, stops fermenting.
Mm-hmm.
That's the port section.
Right.
Then I leave grapes on the vine to freeze that winter. I make ice wine, and then add the ice wine. I gotta get the ice wine fermenting first because you can't add it direct, it's too sweet.
Okay.
After I get it fermented to where my parameters will keep me where I want, then I add it to the tank before it goes into the barrel.
That's very unique. I know why. It's not as rich as you think it would be.
Yeah, it's not as sweet. A lot of people don't like ice wine. It's too sweet.
Yeah, late harvest is a bit halfway. This one's kind of a little bit less than that even.
The sugar's a 9, which is the same as the late harvest.
Oh, so it's about the same as the late harvest? Okay.
Yeah. The alcohol's 18.
Wow. I can see why it's popular.
And the price.
Yeah.
If that was ice wine, it'd be $50.
Exactly.
And you're not selling that many.
Yeah.
Because I used to make ice wine. I made the world's first ice wine for Tempranillo grapes.
Really?
2006 vintage.
Nice.
Yeah. But the bottles just hang around. Like, you're not selling a lot of it.
I'm not surprised by that, actually.
Right. So that's why I made this, and it just flies out the door. I'm now making between 8 and 10,000 bottles a year of this.
Wow. Well, I'll get a pair of those. Absolutely.
Dolce Vita.
And, get me one of the cellar ones.
And one of the cellar releases. Now, if you have this, do decant it.
Yeah.
It's going to have some sediment in it.
Yeah. Okay.
And I would suggest, depending on who you're having it with,
mm-hmm.
I mean, if you're just having it by yourself or with a friend or another, like two people,
then
maybe a second bottle would not be necessary. But what I usually do is I'll have, if I'm having an older wine, like for my birthday, we had a 96 Cabernet Merlot, a 93, and a 91.
What birthday? Was this recently?
Yeah, last June.
Wow, that's amazing.
I have a cellar that goes back 30 years. So what I do is I'll decant this in a decanter.
Slowly. Yeah.
So you keep the, you decant the wine before.
Yeah.
This part's uphill.
Yeah.
So if you start slowly, the sediment will hug this and won't go over.
And won't go over.
No, won't go over.
Yeah.
And you get just a little bit left. Right about there, you've got 98% of the wine out. And just go like that and just get a little bit in the bottle.
And just leave it.
Well, I drink it last. I drink it, no, but not now.
It's drink it, but it's at the end. End of the drink.
So that's in your decanter now, and I will sip it. Say the three of us are having dinner, give it a little bit each, so you can sip it and taste what it tastes like.
Yeah.
And then let it breathe.
All right.
And then start your, it won't take long. It's going to open up in 15 to 30 minutes.
Right.
So, but while you're eating, and when we eat, it's always longer than 30 minutes.
Right.
So then I would open up a regular bottle, say Merlot, and pour people a glass.
Let them drink on that one before you break
and
out.
And then we'll sip this every 5 minutes.
Really?
Take a sip
every
5 minutes. And all of a sudden, you're going to taste the difference. As it opens up, you go, ooh, this is nice. What do you think? We switch.
Yeah. And then you push that the younger bottle aside.
Because that you can finish it after or even have it the next day.
Yeah.
But this, you can't really, shouldn't keep it till the next day.
Is that say a wine you want to clear out?
Yeah, and then you enjoy it while it's peaking in the decanter.
Oh, nice, very nice.
That was quick.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
I thought that was.
Nope.
Oh.
This is Hillside.